top 10 private bee schools in India.
Our focus is on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech, excellence with values.
Having completed your Master's of Business Administration, you'll be wondering, what kind of a world are you going to enter in? What kind of an India are you going to enter in? And what should you do to succeed in this environment? And that's the question I'm going to share with you, a few answers that I think I have based upon whatever I know. The world is at a very strange point in its history. In 1500, and after which India again became the largest economy. And those economies were built on human labor, human skill, and not on motive power. So India was a very rich country to which the Western powers came to trade, and through trade, England conquered this giant country and used the resources of this country to rule the world. Today, in this decade, you're going to see the transformation of economic power from the OECD back towards Asia. India and China made up 45% of world GDP at one point of time, and when this transformation takes place again, this decade, India and China are again going to have 30 to 35%. Many countries which lack capital resources. And this capital coming to a different country means investment and jobs in that particular country. At the same time, innovation cycles are coming down, which I will explain to you later. So as the world opens up, the world becomes one single marketplace. There is an evening out of asset prices, there's an evening out of growth, and the shortage of capital and skill that held back large parts of the world disappeared, and so the entire economy started. Many corporations not able to compete, new corporations coming up, creating very new opportunities. Technology also has another impact. Technology is enhancing the quality of life for people because people are becoming disease-free with drug discovery. At the same time, people are living longer. But if you live longer, your working life is not longer, but your life becomes longer. And when you age in a society, it means the cost of ensuring that a large part of a population which lives longer is kept in reasonable health falls on those people who are much younger who have to pay taxes. And in every society, the dependency ratio is very low. At the percentage of years per person in many, many countries of the world, today in Japan, women live up to 88, men live up to 85. In India, women live up to 67, men to maybe 65. The world average is that women live up to 74, 75, and men maybe up to 69. So with this elongation of life, you're going to see a different kind of business come, different kind of enterprises come all the world. 6 billion mobile devices, 4 billion people who are connected, with many more getting connected every single day. Facebook is becoming the largest country in the world. 1.35 people. Imagine 1.35 billion people connected together on Facebook, creating markets, talking to each other. They're going beyond national boundaries, all as a young consuming community, growing at maybe 15, 20, 25%. And that alone envisages change. So we're going to see technology making deeper and deeper changes, which is awaiting transformation in your hands. The most important thing you need to know and need to have is what I call problem-solving skills. Being managers with an MBA implies that you understand business, you understand the business environment, you understand the challenges at the macro level, you understand the challenges at the micro level, and you're able to gravitate from the micro to the micro and the micro to the macro in the moment's interest. Moment's instance. That means you have to be extremely well-read, you've got to have a problem-solving mindset to analyze business challenges. You've got to have an ability to craft business solutions, and you've got to have an ability to think of strategic directions for your business all at the same time and work towards that goal. So having an analytical framework, analytical mindset, ability to analyze, use data is extremely critical if you have to succeed. The second skill that you need, very important, is communication skills. 10 years ago, if you went for an interview, you got 10 minutes, right? They listen to you and to somebody who wants to hire you or look upon you as a manager. So communication skills are extremely important. The third skill that you need is to be very flexible. Remember, you are in management, you are at a level of domain expertise, but you should have the flexibility to work in any part of the world, not work only in Delhi or in Bangalore. Yes, stepping outside the boundaries, going to join their companies with dream in their eyes and a tilt in their feet, knowing very well that they're going to succeed. But real life is very tough, and real life is very, very different. Don't get disillusioned. Keep your cheer, keep your good humor, keep your optimism, drive yourself crazy, and you will succeed. So wish you well, Godspeed, and God bless you all, and thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your remarkable speech. And we hope from the class of 2014 that we'll see the energy and passion to change the world that is ready to be changed. May I now request our chairperson, Board of Governors, BIMTEC, the director and the registrar, to kindly initiate the diploma award ceremony.